In this video, we are going to discuss about Coulomb's law. On completion of this Coulomb's law, students will be able to use this Coulomb's law equation to make the prediction in the quantity of charge or the separation of distance between this electrostatic forces, and also to use this Coulomb's law equation for solving the unknown quantity, that is force, distance and charges. So see the statement of Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law states that force that is exerted between the two point charges Q1 and Q2 is directly proportional to the product of two charges, and it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So if you are considering the two point charges, that is Q1 and Q2, the distance between these two point charges is separated by the distances R. So the charge Q1 exerts a force on Q2, while this Q2 charge also exerts a force on Q1. This force between the charges we can write as F is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 divided by R square. That is, Q1 and Q2 is nothing but the product of two charges, and R is the distance between these two charges. To remove this proportionality, we can use K. So F is equal to K into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. So here the point charge means nothing but it is the electric charge which is spreaded on the surface. Here it has the location but it does not have the dimensions. This point charge can be either positive or negative. Actually, this charge is the deficiency or excess of electrons in the atoms. So this electron possesses the negative charge. Here we can measure this charge in Coulomb. So 1 Coulomb we can write it as 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ Coulomb, and 1 Coulomb of this charge we can write it as, that is charge which is possessed by 6×10⁸ number of electrons. And also here the unit is given as Newton. So for finding out the force, F is equal to K into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. So here the proportionality value, that is K, is equal to 1/4πε, and the unit of this epsilon is farads per meter. Epsilon is nothing but the permittivity of the medium. So we can write it as epsilon in general as epsilon equal to ε₀ × ε₀r, and the value of this permittivity of free space, that is ε₀, is equal to 8.854×10⁻¹² farads per meter. And we can write this vector form of this Coulomb's form as, that is, if you are considering the point charges Q1 and Q2, which is located at the positions R1 and R2, so we can write this force exerted by Q1 on Q2 along this direction, that is R12, means we can write this as F2 is equal to Q1 Q2 divided by 4πε₀R12² × A12, which we are writing in the form of vector form. So the main observations what we have to know in this Coulomb's law is, that is, force exerted by the two charges, that is, will be equal but they can be in opposite direction. So we can say that is F1 is equal to −F2, and here the like charges will repel each other while the unlike charges will attract each other, as shown in this diagram. And it is necessary that if two charges are point charges, then they should be stationary. And also if the two point charges can be brought together, the same charges will be repel each other and the unlike charges will be attract each other. This point charges may be positive or negative. Based on the signs we are considering, we can calculate the forces here. So the Coulomb's law is linear normally, so we can write it as F2 is equal to −F1. So in the case of calculating this unit vector, that is, if A12, if you are calculating, means we will be calculating this A12 as unit vector along the direction R12. So that is nothing but vector divided by magnitude of the vector. So in vector form, we can represent this as F2 is equal to Q1 Q2 divided by 4πε₀ × R12² × A12. So in the case of principle of superposition, if you are considering more than 2 point charges, means we will be using the principle of superposition. So here the total force is the vector sum of the all the forces. So that we will be calculating using, if FQ is equal to FQ1Q plus FQ2Q plus FQ12Q. So mainly the steps which we have to follow for solving the problem on Coulomb's law is, first we have to obtain the position vector of these points where these charges are located. Then next we have to find out the unit vector along this line charges, and third step we have to find out the force that is exerted in the form of vector, and the fourth step, we if there is more than 2 point charges, means we have to repeat the steps from 1 to 3. So using the principle of superposition, we'll be calculating this force. That is, using this principle of superposition, the vector sum of all the forces calculated is the resultant force. We can calculate this forces of all the charges. So these are the main steps we have to know while solving the Coulomb's law. So here a problem is given. A charge Q1 is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 4 and Q2 is equal to minus 10 power minus 4. So here first we are calculating the position vector where these charges are located. So R12 value we have calculated. Then we are calculating the unit vector, that is A12. So we have find out the position vector as well as the unit vector. So from that, using Coulomb's law, we will be expressing the force exerted in this vector form. So that is nothing but F2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square into A12. So we know the value of Q1 value, Q2 value, epsilon naught value, then R12 value, unit vector value. So we will be applying all those values in this equation, and we can find out the value of the force that is exerted on Q2 by Q1. And here quiz questions on Coulomb's law. So the first question is, decreasing the charge on both particles by a factor of 2 while leaving all other factors the same will cause the force to decrease by the factor of 4. And the second one, the force of attraction or repulsion between two charges is given by which law? That is by Coulomb's law. And the third one is, what is the unit of charge? So the unit of charge is Coulomb. Thank you.